point, nothing but a hound dog.
Hey there, stargazers. I'm Dean Regas, astronomer for the Cincinnati Observatory.
And I'm James Albury, director of the Kika Silva Pla Planetarium in Gainesville, Florida. Fellow stargazer Marlene Hidalgo will join us to help you find your way around the sky. What's with the posing?
Didn't you know that there's a constellation named Elvis in the sky?
No.
Okay, well, it's nothing official, but if you squint and let your imagination go wild, a group of stars looks a little like the king.
Are you talking about Orion? He does have a snazzy belt like Elvis.
I know. Picture Orion as the Elvis in the later years donning his sparkly outfit.
And you know what else he's got? A hound dog.
I love it. Let's show you.
Okay, we have our sky set for any night this week facing southeast at 8 p.m. There you'll easily find the constellation Orion the Hunter standing about halfway up in the sky with his three stars in a row. Okay, Dean, so how exactly does this giant hunter look like Elvis?
You mean beyond the star-studded wardrobe? Well, in the traditional drawing of Orion, he's a hunter holding a club in one hand and a lion skin in the other, trying to fend off a charging bull. That's Taurus over in the right. But what if it's really Elvis wearing a sequin belt, raising a microphone in one hand, holding back his adoring fans with the other?
Wow, that's some imagination. I guess it does look like an Elvis pose.
Thank you very much.
Well, your Elvis is complete with some really bright stars. The bright blue star on his left foot is called Rigel. That could pass as a blue suede shoe. And the reddish star under his right arm is called Betelgeuse. Seems like a funny place to put a sequin.
Rigel is a supergiant star 772 light years from us. It is one of the most luminous stars in the galaxy, shining about 130,000 times brighter than our sun. If Rigel was 25 times closer to us, it would appear many times brighter than any other star or planet in the sky. Only the moon and sun would be brighter. Betelgeuse is about 640 light years away. Its red color tells us a story. It tells us that Betelgeuse has a surface temperature of a little under 6,000 degrees Fahrenheit. Rigel, on the other hand, is bluer and way hotter, over 21,000 degrees. Since Betelgeuse is relatively cool, but still very bright to us on Earth, it must be huge. Let's put our sun next to Rigel, next to Betelgeuse. Yikes, that's a big sequin, I mean star.
Orion, like Elvis, has a hunting dog in the sky. Connect a line through the belt of stars and keep going down and to the left. You'll run into the brightest star in the sky, the dog star, Sirius. The ancients pictured these stars as Orion's larger hunting dog, Canis Major. Sirius marks the nose of the dog, and the other stars make up the feet and body.
Yep, to me that looks exactly like a hound dog. And there's one more connection. Just as the Elvis song says, "You ain't nothing but a hound dog, crying all the time," the star Sirius was a signal to the Egyptians that the rains were coming and the Nile was about to flood.
Also in the Elvis song, the hound dog is chasing a rabbit. Well, lo and behold, there's a rabbit constellation up there too. Look just below Orion's feet and you may see a small four-sided figure of stars with a few others thrown in that mark the constellation Lepus the Hare. So as the stars move over the course of the night from east to west, our hound dog, Canis Major, looks to be chasing after our rabbit, Lepus.
Remember the line, "You ain't never caught a rabbit and you ain't no friend of mine"?
I guess Canis Major will forever be chasing that rabbit, but he'll never catch him.
And Orion seems completely uninterested in his hound dog. He's busy fighting off Taurus the bull.
Oh yeah, certainly doesn't look like a friend of his.
Okay, you convinced me. Orion and Canis Major are really Elvis and his hound dog.
It's fun to put your own spin on the classic constellations. Who knows what you'll see when you keep looking up.